It's hockey night in Southern California. Here they come right off the ice. The championship round, the Bantam Championships, and it's the York Toros taking on the Bay Harbor Devils. Hi, everybody. Johnny Boyle on a frosty California winter morning. Last day of the year, and this should be an interesting one. The York Toros down from Toronto. They are undefeated in the tournament. In their last game, they defeated this same Bay Harbor club. And this is going to be a great, great playoff game.
Championship game between the Red Devils of Bay Harbor and the York Toros of Toronto. Would you all please rise now for the playing of our national anthems?
Beautiful strains of Old Canada, followed by the Star Spangled Banner. You know, I love that ceremony in hockey. I really do. I know folks who used to tune into Ranger Canadian games in New York and Ranger Maple Leaf games and now Ranger Vancouver Canuck games in New York just to hear the playing of the Canadian national anthem, believe it or not. One of the most beautiful of all the anthems, O Canada, followed by the Star Spangled Banner. That's a nice way to start off this international final. Well, we've seen the Toros play two games. We have two of their games on videotape. A fine victory over Clarkson, and they beat this Bay Harbor team yesterday. Bay Harbor trying to do what would be considered to be a big upset, take the York Toros today. Now we have a new goalie. We have not seen Carmelo Gurlio in the Twins. He's number one. He had a chat with his dad early on in the tournament. Carmelo will be number one. David DeMauro, number two. Robert Fernicola, three. Steve Paluzzi, four. Andrea Mastandrea, number seven. Luis Savaglio, number nine. Mark Sapino, number 10. This is all for the blue shirt of Toros. Tom Carnevale, number 15. Mark Carriero, number 16. Mike Wolchek, number 19. Louis Cashley, 21. 23, Chris Posny. And on the draw, the Toros control the Toros in the blue. And there's the first blast of the game. Jesse Napier in the Twines. for Bay Harbor. Here comes the attacking Bay Harbor. That's Armstrong. Scotty's shot. Sticked aside by Carmelo as he gets his first action in this contest. Well, these two teams, we know each other. They played just a day ago. Bay Harbor playing without Richard Park, one of their better players. Here's Flynn shooting a high one. Wow. Into a pile of players. You can see heads and helmets and birdcages ducking there. And now play is called along the sideboards. Let me finish the lineup here. Number 25 is Sasha Rani Chavalier. We had a chance to speak with Sasha yesterday, a fine young man. Alex Villa, number 27, Sam Iaboni. Sam not playing today. He played in the Nets earlier in this tournament. And David Vigilante, 77. The coach is Vince Vigilante. The assistant coach, John DeLeo, and Tony Federico is the manager. Jesse Napier is in the Nets for Bay Harbor. Their backup goalie is Jeff Daly. Eric Keady is number 8. Todd Gibson, number 9. John Wilton, number 11. Donald Medeiros, number 15. Mike Fitzpatrick, number 16. Jimmy Lefebvre, number 34. Robert Flynn, 36. Jonathan Castine, 35. Bill Utak, 55. Randy Hemming, 88. And Ronnie Marshall, one of their big guns, 91. Bob Marshall is the coach for Bay Harbor's Red Devils. And in the course of this five-day tournament, we've had a chance to meet with and speak with some of these players from both sides. I'm from New York, so I'm pretty well neutral in this regard. Fine young men, all of them, believe me. I've enjoyed speaking with them. Now, Big Bill on the faceoff, number 55. He draws it back. That's Gibson in the center zone. Gibson pounds it off the boards. We're playing two 15-minute periods running time. Then the last period will be stop time, NHL-type stop time. Nice headman pass, but it's intercepted. Toro's operating on the near wing. Lewis Cashley, 21. Toro's regain at their blue line. Here's Cashley again. Cashley tries to work it up to Carriero. Well, with fond regards to all our good friends in the Great Dominion of Canada, is Armstrong, Scotty Armstrong, trying to feed Utak. Intercepted. Toro's flying up the ice, two men, and they bump Luis out of the play and along the boards. Bay Harbor, long lead pass. And it's an offside pass. So play will be returned to the Bay Harbor end of the ice. Again, with fond holiday greetings to all our friends in Canada. I've spent a lot of time in Toronto. Used to wrestle up at Maple Leaf Gardens. Used to watch the Leafs play in the Marlboros. Hello to everybody around Yonge Street and King Street. A great, great swinging town, Toronto, Ontario. With a great hockey tradition with the Maple Leafs. Not doing so well this year, but these young players from Toronto more than holding up their own in the great Toronto hockey tradition here in Southern California. Maybe Boward Smith might want some of these boys very soon. And Carmelo, oh, look at that as the official skates in there, right at Carmelo Grelio's feet. I know Carmelo's dad proud of him. He spoke to me before the tournament even started. He said he wanted to get him a tape of his young man playing goal down here in Southern California. So far, he's doing very well. No score. We played 4.5 minutes. Eric Hindy on the draw. Works it to Utak. The shot is blocked by the defense of the Toros, and they start up. They've got a 2-on-2. From the end boards, Toros keep it in. York just noted for their passing, at least in this tournament. They have just done such a great job. There's a shot and a score! And the first goal of the game as they work it around beautifully. Drive it by Jesse on the short left side. And there's a score. So Fernicola out there for the score, and Vigilante gets the plus one. Manny Savelyev, 25, in on that. Boy, nice score. Alex Villa, we've had a couple of chats with Alex. He's a real personality out there. You're going to see him some night on Hockey Night in Canada. Alex Villa, the scorer. And it's 1-0 for the Toros. The goal came just at about the 5-minute mark of the period. First period of play. And another hard shot on Napier, as Ranishelnia put the shot on, and Sasha's shot is turned away, and a rebound. Napier under the gun. Sticks now go high in front of the net, as Gibson trying to ride the Toros forward away. Nice head man there. Utak can't get by Fernicola, though Fernicola goes down. Bill was bodied at the blue line, and it threw the play offside. Well, Dennis Lefebvre can be proud of his son. I always mispronounce that name. I think of it as the way the Yankee player used to pronounce his name, but it's pronounced the way Jim Lefebvre pronounced it. Dennis Lefebvre, in charge of this tournament, can be proud of his young man there. Number 34, Jim. Real sturdy little player out there in the white shirt. Castine tries to stop the Toros from breaking out. Mike Sapino led the charge down the near boards. Bay Harbor's got a lot of rooters here today. There's a loose stick. Penalty called. And so Sapino, who led the charge down the ice, draws a 3-minute penalty. Again, it's 3 minutes during running time in the first and second periods. 7:09 to play in the opening stanza. It's 1-0 for York. Mike Walchuk on the draw. He's out there in the penalty killing unit for the Toros. As is Carriero. Thomas, number 16. Lewis Cashley, 21. One-man advantage. Cashley, now that was Paluzzi, had to go off his stick. As the Devils dump it in, Toros can't clear. Marshall puts it right in front off the stick of Carmelo, and it play ties up in the far corner. 6:24 to go in the period, 2:19 to go in the one-man power play for Bay Harbor. And Gibson will be out there, and Armstrong, Medeiros. They're looking for the tying score. Medeiros on the draw, follows it into the corner, but York ices the puck. Randy Hemming, the other forward out there, 89 for Bay Harbor. Minute and a half to go in the power play, 5.5 to go in the period. Bay Harbor on the attack. Here's Hemming. Stopped in center, regains, dumps it in. York takes possession at their blue line, and York sends it up ice again. Gibson operates from the Bay Harbor line. Tries to find Medeiros, taken away by the Blue Shirts. And they send it back again behind Jesse Napier. Long pass to Armstrong. Here's Scott at center. Over the line to Medeiros. Medeiros feeds his winger Marshall. Marshall puts it in front, trying to find Armstrong right at the post of Carmelo. It scores, and it's 1-1! Bay Harbor scores on the power play. 1-1. Medeiros, Marshall, and Armstrong all buzzing around the net. One apiece. Even size. Castine cannot stop DeMauro. Hard shot. And Jesse has it under his pads. 4:05 to go. So Bay Harbor gets the equalizer here in the first period. It's been a very fast first period of play. Some of the York boys are telling me they've had trouble in championship games or final games. They feel they might even be jinxed. Well, we'll see. But we've seen them play, and I doubt they're going to be jinxed. They play so well. Hard shot blocked by the defense. Bay Harbor has an opening as the defenseman falls. In come the Devils, a shot, and it's just wide. Oh, boy. Good opportunity there for the left winger as he came streaking in. But it was nicely covered up. Now Udek is stopped in center by Vanny Sadlev. Sasha Rani Shaboliev. That's a beautiful sounding name. I love it. Euphonic. Here's Ronnie Marshall, and he streaks in. I said on another tape that Ronnie Marshall reminds me of Donnie Marshall, who used to play for the Rangers and Canadians years ago. Puck is tucked in on the boards. 2:33 to go in the first stanza. 1-1 the score. It's been a really good one. Bay Harbor looking better. They said they were going to do some line changes today to try to counteract the swift Toros. Toros now cannot keep it in. It comes back into their defensive zone. And Master Andrea, number 7, tries to start the play. It winds behind the net. We get these lineups, as I've said, just before the game starts. We're doing these four championship games back-to-back. But we've had a chance now to see the Toros a couple of times. I'm getting to be, quite frankly, a little bit more familiar with their names and their playing styles. Now that's Donald Medeiros skating over to the penalty box with the official. Actually, to the... to the penalty box. He's gone now for 3 minutes. And we will have a look at the power play for the York Toros as the faceoff is being brought out beyond the Toros blue line. Killing the penalty will be Marshall. Bobby Flynn. As the Toros get possession in their own defensive zone. Pernicola back to cover it for the Canadians. Canadians and Californians, good matchup. A lot of Canadians living here in Southern California. Jack Ken Cook was one of them, brought hockey to the fabulous form. When they asked him why the Kings didn't draw better, this is pre-Gretzky days, he said, yes, we have a lot of Canadians down here. They're the only Canadians who don't like hockey. Aren't many of them. Walchuk started it up the near boards. Play behind Napier. And Bay Harbor ices the puck. It's cut off just short of the goal line. And now the referee turns around and we're going to have a penalty called. I think he only saw the last infraction there. Oh, Bay Harbor's fans livid at that one. Referee Moody was, of course, watching the play, turned around and saw the retaliation as so often happens. Let's see how this is all going to get sorted out. The period is going to end before any more action. 1 second, no seconds. We have a 1-1 tie at the end of one period. And although it may be a tie, the second period will begin with the Toronto Toros having a two-man advantage for 1 minute and 41 seconds. So Bay Harbor will be under the gun, and there's going to be some fast and furious skating. We'll come back and bring you all the action here at the Bay Harbor Christmas Tournament. Jesse Napier is going to be under the gun. He knows it. His team is starting two men down. And we have a hunch the blue shirts are going to be coming his way in just a moment. On the draw, that's Alex Villa. Goes behind the net. Randy Hemming out there trying to kill the penalty along with Marshall, and play ties up in the corner. Boy, the best hope for Bay Harbor right now would be to draw another penalty, quite frankly, draw concurrent penalties. They can't lose any more men, but York, of course, can. 1-1 tie in the first period. Clock is running, 1:08 to go in the first penalty. Two-man advantage for the Toros. The Toros bring it right to the doorstep of Jesse. It goes behind the net. On the attack out there is Poshny, 23, nicely iced. And there's a good break for Bay Harbor. Good work, I should say. It goes behind Carmelo Gurlio. Broken up at center by Hemming with the Toros on the march. Here they come. Marshall tries to stop them. Play goes into the corner, and it's iced again by Bay Harbor. So Bay Harbor showing a lot of moxie. They've iced it twice. They'll still be two men down for 32 seconds, and then they'll be one man down for 1:20 or thereabout. Toros on the march again. On the free wing here is Villa. Toros work it down. Alex has it from behind the net. Tries to pass out in front. Right in front now. Dead on shot. Stopped by Napier. Rebound. Score! 2-1. And I'll tell you, you just can't give these York boys a two-man advantage. That's just like giving away a goal, frankly. These guys are just too good. A heroic defense for Bay Harbor. They did very well, but they just couldn't keep it out of the net. It is 2-1. So Alex Villa and his boys, boy, oh boy, they are tough. Okay, 2-1. Scott Armstrong now will draw. Still a power play, one-man power play. Walchuk is stopped in center. Toros reform. Paluzzi was looking for a pass on the blue line, but the defenseman banged it off the backboard. Paluzzi goes in to try to get the dump. They work it right in front again. Heavy traffic in front of Napier. They hold it out. Puck comes back in center. 19 seconds to go in the power play. Second period, 2-1 for the Toros. Play in the corner, Flynn down. We've got a man right at the doorstep. Steve Paluzzi trying to pop it by Jesse Napier. Out it comes. It's on the defense, takes care of it, and ices it nicely. Well, unfortunately, though, for Bay Harbor, it was even sides by that time, and it'll be an icing the puck. It'll come all the way back down again. Still, though, if you're not sure, it's better to ice it and get rid of it in that situation. So the Toros get one goal out of the power play. They scored it just before the first penalized Devil came back on, and that was still pretty good defensive play for the Californians. David DeMauro will face it off for York. DeMauro tries to draw it back to Master Andrea. Toro's controlling. They started off the period with a two-man advantage, and they're keeping the pressure on now at even size. They drive right in again. That shot flies by Napier. Look at that number 25, Sasha Manisavljev, out there on the point. Sasha can't keep that one in. So play will stop. We'll have a change. We have played 4.5 minutes into the second period, and it's 2-1 for the Toros. Toros are undefeated. On the faceoff, Toros from the backboard. Ten minutes to play in the period. Here comes Bay Harbor. And play is called. So the icing brings it all the way back now. Bay Harbor having trouble getting an attack going in this period. I believe that's Chris Poshny on the draw this time, 23. He circles right in front, he backhands it. Saved by Napier. On the end boards again. Bay Harbor just having trouble getting it out of their zone now. This has been 5 minutes of pressure by the Toros. Toros tell me they tend to start slowly and then they'll pick it up as it goes along. That might be the case. This Kazegas trying to steal in center. And Kazegas headmans it nicely. 34, Jimmy Lefebvre. Carmella gets a little action there. Now Hemming. Randy Hemming, big number 88 on defense. He's back there. Here's the Toros breaking in, and it's put to the side. That was covered up nicely by the defense. Forward and on the twines. Tipped right in front. Oh, just missing. A nice deft touch there. The Toros almost able to collect on that one. Right in front again. Here's Big Bill. Utek from the sideboards. Clears the zone. Suits it down into the Toro zone. It's over the end line. It'll be icing. We'll take a break with 8 minutes and a few seconds to play. And it's 2-1 for the Toros. So the Toros keep on the pressure. Number seven there, Andrea Mastrandrani. It's a beautiful euphonic name, isn't it? Mastra Andrea. Number seven, skating around there. Okay, now we're going to get a look at Bay Harbor's power play. They need a score to tie it up. They will be one man up. I didn't catch the number there, but I think that might be number 10, Mark Sapino. We'll check it for you. Now number 10's on the ice. In fact, he's killing the penalty, so we'll try to see who the penalized player was. Bill tries to find Ronnie Marshall on the near wing. Oh, Ronnie is spun hard off into the boards. Todd Gibson stops the Toros from breaking out, but they do now move it at the center. Mike Walchuk, number 19. And here's a penalty being called. Gibson was hit in the back of the head. Let's see if this is going to be a two-man advantage for Bay Harbor. And indeed it is. And here is their opportunity to get the tying score. Certainly two men up. Well, I guess I anticipated that. That's Mike Sapino going in the box. So that leaves Master Andrea out there. Mike Walchuk and Robert Furnicola performed the triangular defense. But it's going to be a double penalty we see now, so it's going to be four skaters. No, it is. It's a two-man advantage. Pardon me, a two-man advantage. Medeiros out there with Marshall on the attack. Now, Bay Harbor from their blue line. Two-man advantage for a minute and 49 seconds. Golden opportunity for the Devils, and play ties up along the sideboards as one of the Toros goes down hard. Scott Armstrong weighing the check. Probably got a look at Napier when he was facing a two-man advantage. Carmelo Gurlio now under the gun. Two men. Two extra shooters against him. Headman it to Marshall. Ronnie from the boards. Oh, he's bodied hard by Master Andrea. 5:15 to go in the period, 2-1 for the Toros. Bay Harbor trying their best here to get the tying score, and a Bay Harbor player goes head first into the boards. Utak keeps it in. Bay Harbor hustling, bouncing puck, Armstrong right in front, a shot, a score! A power play goal, 2-2. Bay Harbor ties it up. The puck bouncing wildly in front of goalie Carmelo. A little number 66, Kazanis out there. We saw his little brother, I believe, in an earlier game. He's just a little scooter out there, Camille Henry type play. Utak feeds Gibson at his blue line. His play is underway. 2-2, 4:23 to go. Chance now for York. Still a power play. York looking for a shorthander. Nice pack. Finds Cazadas right at center ice. Return pass up the ice to Utak. And the puck finally goes astray and goes into the boards. Bay Harbor playing much better today than they did last night. And they can't keep it in. Robert Flynn has to shoot it back. Toros dump it at the center. Todd with a long one. Hand it aside. Put back out and iced nicely by Toronto. Look at Alex Villa in there, forechecking. 24 seconds to go in the power play. 3:28 to go in the period. 2-2 the score. Final game of the holiday tournament. Cazadas dumps it in. Here's Paluzzi behind the net. Works it to Cashley. And they ice it again with 8 seconds to go in the advantage. Napier stops it. Jesse's been a busy boy. Carmelo's had a lot of work, too, here in the second period. Hard check there. And a penalty is Donald Medeiros is going to be called, I guess, for charging or elbowing, I would suspect. So with 2:54 to go in the period, it'll be a one-man advantage for York. Medeiros disputes the call. Check didn't look too bad, but I think George got a good shot of that one for you, and you can run it back and look at it for yourself. Hemming, Armstrong, trying to get the rest of the penalty killing unit for you. Flynn and Marshall out there now to kill the penalty, which will take up the rest of the period. Savaglio, number 9, that little Lewis is so fast out there for the Toros. We've seen him in earlier games. On the draw, Toros start the attack at their line. Armstrong tries to stop him, but the Toros break it through. Savaglio going towards the net. Henning, big tall defenseman in there behind the net. Nicely sent all the way down and iced by Bay Harbor. Minute and 50 to go. One man power play advantage for the Toros. Hosny. And now Vigilante in front of the net. Down goes the goalie. Down goes one of the Toros at the back of the net. David Vigilante goes around to help his fallen teammate. The clock will keep running. The net is off the hinges. This is a great break for Bay Harbor. They're a man down, and the clock is running that penalty out for them at 1:18 to go. To kill off a penalty. It's all the way down to 1 minute or thereabout before action will begin. On the draw, Toros from the corner. 2-2 the score. Savaglio right at the corner of the net there with Hemming trying to guard him. Now Luis passes out from the side. Actually, they keep it in the goal area. Look at that action right behind Jesse Napier. Now Hemming, Randy is hemmed in by the Blue Shirts. And play is called along the board. So that time, the Toros couldn't get much going. Clock is running down, less than half a minute. The Toros' power play continues, but as the lines change, they're not going to have much of a chance to put another shot on net. Bay Harbor has played a much better game here in this second try at the visiting Toronto Toros. 5 seconds to go in the period. Vigilante standing over there, but most of this penalty period has been run out on line changes. What's the official going to say now? Even though the clock has run out, is he going to put some more time on it? He is. At least we're going to get the drop of the puck. Because really, that last minute and a half saw almost no action. Vigilante is looking for a faceoff. Here's the drop. 1 second on, two, three. Hard shot. Flies wide. How much time It runs down again to 2 seconds, 1 second, and there it is. He put about 7 or 8 seconds back on the clock as some of the boys come together there just as the period ends. That's Louis Cashley, 21, skating away. Well, we have had two scintillating periods. One of the Red Devils down, also in his defensive zone. He's getting to his feet now. As there's some milling and talking, Vigilante, I believe the captain there, talking with the referee with the orange stripe on his shirt. But we have played two, and it has been a humdinger. A 2-2 score. The third period will start like the second on a power play for the Toros. They will have one man to the good, and we'll be bringing you the final period of regulation time in this Bantam match in the Bay Harbor Holiday Tournament. It's 2-2. Anybody's game for the championship of this tournament, and the Toros bring it in offside as we start play. Toros in the blue. They're going to the left, where goalie Jesse Napier wants to hold the fort. On the other end, goalie Carmelo Gurlio, and he's done a good job for his team today. Let me tell you, number one, I like seeing goalies wear the number one. In my day, teams only had one goalie, and it was always number one. When they added the second, it became 1 in 31 for the most part. But I like seeing goalies keep the tradition of wearing the big number one. It used to be that the goalie was number one and the all-star defenseman was number two. Things have changed a little bit. 55, Bill Otak on the draw, won by the Toros. And recaptured and sent down on Carmelo. He clears it off to the side. We've had good goaltending in this game, by the way. Both netminders doing a fine job. Good goals as well. Right in front at the doorstep of Carmelo, and he flicks it aside. Oh, a close call as Bay Harbor almost had the leader. Mike Walchuk tries to make the return attack, but the rush is stopped. Toros continue the play. And just as Louis Cashley kept it in, play is called. Here's Louis, number 21, circling. Get a look at the Toros, the nice Brahma Bull face on the shirts of the blue shirts as Louis skated towards you there. Toros. Tell you, you give them an extra man and they are so frightening that it's almost like giving them a goal. You know, the rule was changed during the heyday of the Montreal Canadiens some years ago. It used to be if there was a penalty and a goal was scored, the penalized man stayed off anyway. Andre Mastriandrada bangs it off the backboards. Out it comes. Mastriandrada again, number seven in center. Skating with him is DeMauro. Up the side it goes. Walchuk is bodied. Toro is working in behind Napier. Still have it. Good forechecking there. David Madera. Pardon me, Donald Medeiros didn't let his man get away. Out, it's off the stick of Palmer. It goes into the corner again. Walchuk follows it down. Tips it out. Kept in nicely by Mastriandrada. And out it comes down to center. Walchuk. So far, good penalty killing by Palmer and his mates. DeMauro. Puck ties up in the corner. 36 seconds to go in the one-man advantage for the Toros. Toros not as fast today as we've seen them before. Or perhaps they're getting more of the body this time from the California boys. That's nicely flicked. And here comes Donnelly, shoots. Oh, Carmelo comes up big. Nice play. Play of the game there. Comes up the other way, and DeMauro bangs it. And we almost had a score each way. Wow. We have played 2 minutes and 20 seconds or thereabout. Toros lose it in the offensive zone. No call. Yes, tripping. Tripping call. Delayed penalty. Out of the net comes Napier, but the whistle sounds. One of the Toros down in the boards. And you see Lefevre and Palmer and Banderas. Well, flubber your action there. We'll have even sides for 5 seconds. This is now stop time. And then Bay Harbor will go on the attack, at least theoretically, with the power play for a minute and 55 seconds. It's a 2-2 tie. Well, the Toronto boys said they do have trouble in the finals, and Bay Harbor giving them, you know, all they want right now. There's no doubt about it. The York Toros are going to be the favorite in this game. And the California kids doing their best and doing very well so far. But the Toros break it out. They're a man down. Armstrong trying to stop them. And the white shirts break up the play. Now, power play, one man advantage. But it's off the blocker there of Napier. And now, as we come into the final, most important part of the game, we're getting a little temper flare-ups. Play is intense. 12-12 to go. In fairness, I have to say that the Toros did not get much use out of that last power play due to the fact the clock ran down during line changes during, I'd say, a good, oh, three-fifths of it. Play is called once again on the circle. Palmer, Marshall, pardon me, slips it over to the referee. That passes behind the winger. Back to Medeiros, he loses in the offensive zone. Oh, it almost scooted through anyway. Sent back up. This is Gibson circling in his own line. Gibson being watched by Carriero. And Fernicola tries to send it out. Carriero, Fernicola out there. Penalty killing. Hard shot by Marshall. Goes off the skates of Carriero. Here's Vigilante. Minute and two to go in the one-man advantage. Vigilante is stopped at the blue line, but he does get it over. That's forwarded in front where the defense stops it. For Bay Harbor, Marshall, oh, well, inadvertently trips up Vigilante. No call. Here's Armstrong. Armstrong is ridden off as he comes down the near boards. The Toros take it over. Vigilante. He's the alternate captain. Castine makes the play. Finds Utak. Utak bangs it off the backboards. And there's some sparring right in front of us. And we're going to have roughing, I think.
Oh, bullshit!
Let's see. Vigilante was sparring. Let's see with who. Is that Castine? 35. And John is going to go. And David as well. So, coincidental minor penalties for roughing at 11:01. Tie game and 11 minutes to go in the holiday tournament. Wow. And there'll be some empty ice out there now as the two teams will play each one man down. Okay, now there's another penalty rung up on the board as well. And so the two coincidentally penalized players will sit out 2 minutes. There's 29 seconds to go, which will give a power play opportunity. I don't know what the delay is, quite frankly. Here comes the referee as well now. So four skaters to three, and it's Flynn out there now for the white-shirted Devils. Len Lefevre and Utak. Bill faces off. Toros win it at their blue line. Off the boards it comes. 24 seconds to go in the one-man advantage. Then it'll be even side for about a minute and a half. What have we here? A penalty in the defensive zone. Looks like it's on one of the Blues. Referee didn't, let's say it's on number 21, I believe, Lewis Cashley. He was either pointing to 21 or 7. And it is Andre Mastrandrea. So Mastrandrea will be set off. The ice getting depopulated, folks. We're going to have open tundra out there soon.
It's football time, Flynn.
Big chance now for Bay Harbor. Bay Harbor is skating with the extra man. Flynn has it at the blue line. Nicely put off the backboards. Luzak tries to keep it in. He's dumped. And it's ice. Well, look at that, a rolling puck. That was dangerous. It was rolling on its end. There was no telling where it was going to go. Napier turns it aside.
Somebody go in. Help me out.
Right in front, but nobody there.
Take him.
Out comes Cashley.
Take him.
Cashley loses to Flynn. Here's Bobby. Bobby whips it over to Utak at his blue line. Power play continuing. Ronnie Marshall. Marshall in center. Makes his pass to Gibson. Gibson's pass is intercepted and Hemming gets control. Randy at the blue line. Tries to power his way by. He stopped. Marshall gets control. One-on-one. Only for Nicola back. Marshall comes in. Hit the post! Hit the post! It went by Carmelo and it hit the post. But you got to remember, the post is part of the goaltender's equipment. At least that's the way we goalies look at it. Hard blast by Randy. Boy, that was a chance for Bay Harbor to go ahead. Bay Harbor playing much better today than they did last night. This has been a great game. Here's Pernicola. Drives it up in center. Headmans it. One man break. Here's Poshny. Oh, boy. And for a moment, it looked as though it was going to be a breakaway. Now it's returned. Randy Hemming. Randy crisscrossing with Marshall. Marshall right in. He shoots. Couldn't get it between the legs of the goalie. He got it into the crease. Oh, Marshall. Ronnie Marshall almost had that one in. Wow. And credit Carmelo. Didn't give him an inch. Carmelo and Jesse, the two opposing net miners, doing a great job. Marshall collides with Steve Paluzzi. Paluzzi is hurt right in front of us. That was inadvertent, but Paluzzi is down and injured. We'll take a break right in front of us. When Ronnie hit him, he realized he had hurt him, and he stopped actually playing at that point. And we're really sorry to see this happen. It's right play right in front of us here. Number 77, Davey Vigilante looking on. And let's take a break, George, for a moment. The score is 2-2. For Steve Paluzzi, shaking up on that play. Louis Cashley, 21, skating off there with him, and I'm glad it's no worse than that. As I say, when Marshall bumped him, the boy started to crumple, and you could see Marshall actually almost stop playing and almost start to reach out to catch him. You could tell he was shaken up right at that point, and I'm really glad. Nothing more than that. I'm glad the Bay Harbor boys actually out there, the Bay Harbor adults also actually out there to help the young man to his feet. And so 8:41 to go in the regulation time. We're playing even sides right now. The penalized player will be back in 9 seconds, and there'll be a power play, and that's Steve Udick on the draw. Armstrong moves it down the right boards. Nice headman pass. Vigilante up the side. There's Cashley. Fires a long one. Napier puts it to the sideboards. Extra man now for the Toros. The Toros have the power play for a minute and 24. 8:03 to go in the game. 2-2 is the score. In regulation. Hemming. He covers in his own zone. Finds Armstrong. One man back. Hickam Scott tries to deke. He shoots. Carmelo makes the save. Doesn't give an inch. Nice play by the defenseman there, too. He kept the forward well out. Wouldn't let him get the angle on the shot. Now there's Flynn and Heedy out there to kill the penalty, along with Hemming. Eric Heedy will face off. Toros send it out of their zone into center. Randy bangs it off the boards. Here come the Toros, flying down the right wing. Extra man for a half a minute. They can't get it through the defense of the white shirts, but they keep it in the zone. Forward pass there, intercepted. And the Devils skate it out the center. Butak looking for a pass on the blue line, heading, circling 88 and 55, respectively. Now a 3-on-2, Vigilante bangs it hard, it just flies wide, ooh! Jesse shot down hard, and that one didn't miss the corner by much. Vigilante, David's got a good shot, now play ties up in the corner. And after that injury, there was a little pall on the game there for just a minute or two, and now play is called. Both sides changing. 7:02 to go. 2-2 the score. Boy, this has been a good one, hasn't it? Bay Harbor giving them all they could ask for in this one, this contest. Now Medeiros out there. He's number 15. There was a penalty call there as well. Now there's a lot of open ice. 4 against 3. Another penalty on Bay Harbor. Shot off the stick of Napier. And now it's even sides. 4 against 4. Just for a second there. The Toros have the extra man. So that icing the puck brings the faceoff to the left of Jesse Napier. It's a 2-2 score. 6:29 to go in the period. Regulation time. Score is tied. This is much better than the Bay Harbor, and I think their supporters thought their boys might do, but they are hanging tough. They're playing great. Pernicola from the corner. Bay Harbor sends it back on Carmelo. Carmelo with a nice pass. If they could score on this play, he'd get an assist. Here comes Damoro, riding in, around the defenseman, trying to shovel it forward. Hard shot. Ooh. Boschny trying to put it on Napier. Still 4-on-4. Marshall is boarded heavily, and the Toros take it up the other way. Pernicola again on the near wing. Tries to go around Gibson. Medeiros takes him into the corner. Nice pass there. Marshall alone with one defenseman, one man to beat. He goes around him. He comes in. Goalie comes out, but Marshall can't control a rolling puck. Marshall with a great try there. Ronnie Marshall almost stick handle that one in. Medeiros at the blue line. And play is called. Right on the blue line, that's Donald, number 15. And here's a penalty now being assessed to Marshall. He will do 2. So even sides, well, a one-man advantage now. And 4 against 3 for 17 seconds, and then the rest of the power play for a minute and 53 seconds. So the Toros will have the extra man as Gibson dumps it in. With 5:14 to go, the Toros will have the extra man for 2 of those minutes. Here's Toronto on the rush. Randy Hemming trying to stop him. He sweeps in on Napier, carries it behind the net, onto the boards. And it's ice by Bay Harbor, right onto the stick of Gurlio. Carmelo feeds his defenseman. Now it's 5 skaters to 4. With Marshall in the penalty box. That's pounded off the boards. Oh boy, Vigilante put into the boards by Medeiros. And Sasha Ranislav tries to bring the play in. 39 to go. A minute and 20 in Marshall's penalty. Mark Carriero, number 16, skates off. Here's Luis Savaglio. Savaglio feeds Villa. Got to look out for that Alex out there, boy. He's a tricky one. 77, Vigilante starting it off. There's Alex. He's fast. He tries to go around Flynn. Lefebvre, pardon me. Lefebvre, 34. Flynn, 36 for the white shirts. York throws it to the point. A hard shot. Jesse makes the save. 51 seconds to go in the penalty period and 4 minutes and 7 seconds to go in regulation. And there's a score by the Toros! They're hugging Vigilante. And Villa out there. Oh boy, a power play goal. Toros get the score when they needed it. And a tough turn of events for Bay Harbor. With Marshall in the penalty box, the Toros score. 4:05 to go in regulation, 3-2 the score. The winner, the Bantam champions in the Bay Harbor Holiday Tournament. And now even sides, and you would think these last 4:05 in regulation will be penalty free, you would think. Toros don't want to give them an extra man. This is Eric Heady on the draw. Utak tries to muscle his way through. Toros, though, gain possession. Here they come, down behind Napier. Tell you, both teams have played very well, win or lose. Both teams really comporting themselves with class out here today. Vigilante operating from the point. And it's a stoppage of play. Well, we'll watch Jesse Napier in the net. I suspect that if Bay Harbor doesn't get a score within a minute or two, we'll be seeing him heading for the bench and an extra skater coming on. Utek on the draw. Master Andrea gets possession, dumps it in. And there's Flynn, 36. There's a chance. And it's stolen. Toros take it away. Flynn bodies Carriero. And play swirls up behind Napier. Fernicola taking it to the boards. Flynn on the bottom of the pile there. 3:07 to go. 3-2 for the York Toros. Toros undefeated in this tournament. They beat Bay Harbor pretty decisively last night. Tonight, or this afternoon, it's anybody's game. Sticks go high there for a minute. It's a long pass. Onside. Scott going to the net. The shot. Open net for a moment. Oh, my goodness. And it looked as though Bill and Scott might have a chance. Here's Medeiros putting one on Carmelo. And now play is called behind the net. Looks like a penalty coming up on York. Or is it now? Let's see. I thought Napier was skating off there, but he's just moving down the ice. Oh boy, that was Bay Harbor's chance. So Gibson, Medeiros, Marshall, and Armstrong out there. For Bay Harbor. There's a penalty against the Toros with 2:33 to go. We're all but a half minute of that. Bay Harbor will have the extra man. The whistle blows immediately almost on the faceoff. Two of the boys start to square off. And we wish the best for Steve Peluzzi there, by the way. Number four on the Toros. The Fever out there, number 34. The Barris, Armstrong. Here comes Flynn out now as the Fever skates off. Big Hemming on defense. That's the power play. The three blows his whistle. There's 2:33 to go in the game. A two-minute, one-man advantage for Bay Harbor. This place will go crazy if they tie it up. Cashley out there to kill the penalty. And the Toros ice the puck. And I wonder if they might take Napier to the bench and go with two extra skaters. Headman to Armstrong. Armstrong is bodied. Beautiful check there. Medeiros gets it, flips it in high. Palmer, Marshall tries to pull it down. He can't direct it. All you can do is slap it. Vigilante breaks apart from the Devil player. I thought they might just be starting to go at it there in the offensive zone for the Devils. Well, you folks in Canada, hopefully watching this tape, are enjoying it. Seeing these California lads make a good account of themselves against the high-flying Toros, the tough Toros, the terrible Toros, and the terrific Toros. Hard shot wide of Carmelo. 2 minutes to play in the game. Minute and 26 of the penalty. Clean breakaway. Here come the Toros. All the way. Deke shoots. Is it in? It's off the hinges, and it's a goal. Alex Villa broke away, scored the shorthanded goal, and the goalie, Jesse, is injured. Oh, that's a shame. Shorthanded goal. Makes it 4-2. Napier down, being attended to by Bay Harbor players with the net off the hinges. So we will take a break with a minute and 52 seconds to go. And York Toros lead 4-2. Okay, Jesse Napier is skating around back there. If that goal was indeed scored by Alex Villa, I don't know if Alex has a nickname, but as a sportscaster, I'm going to give him one. I'm going to call him Alex the Hat because he's got that great fedora he wears as we've seen him around the arena. And boy, he's a speedster. And I believe we're going to have a replacement now. Let me see if Jesse is coming out here in just the last few seconds of play. It's number 31, and I don't have a 31 on my roster, I'm sorry to say, for Bay Harbor. I believe their substitute goalie is Jeff Daly. I could be wrong on that, but let's see. Minute and 50 to go, 4-2. Bay Harbor now, they still might pull the goalie and try to go out there with an extra skater. Again, the injuries to the two lads, to Napier and Peluzzi, taking a little bit of the tinsel off the tree here at the holiday tournament with York with a two-goal lead. Now, Lewis Cashley is sent off, so is it double penalties? It's going to be 4-on-4 with Flynn, Armstrong, Hemming out there against three defenders, 4-on-3, power play, extra man. If the goalie is pulled, it would give him a 5-on-3. Minute 37 to go, a broken stick on the ice. Well, Bay Harbor's got to get two. If they can get one, they've got their chances. Goalie, though, staying put for the moment. Armstrong behind the net. I'm looking back to see if there'll be a movement from the net by the Bay Harbor goalie. Bay Harbor wisely trying to pin the puck to the end boards. And now Tipper's flaring just a little bit. Two men in the box for the Toros. One for Bay Harbor. Play is called with a minute and 17 to go. Well, this game's had a little bit of everything, folks. I'm sorry it's had the two injuries, but beyond that, it's been a very, very good game. There's Luis Savaglio, number 9, going back to the bench. Now another penalty will make it even sides, and that's what we have. So if George can give us a look at the scoreboard, it's lit up like a Christmas tree right now. All four penalties at different times. Doesn't much matter, though. Only one man is coming back before the minute and 16 run out. Equal size here, just for a moment. Hard body check right in front of us there as Utak is knocked down. Is that Steve Paluzzi back out there again? Is that four? I'm glad to see it is. Well, Steve is back, and I'm very glad to see that. Paluzzi dumps it down. Here's Utak retrieving it. Torres will have an extra man now for a few seconds. Is Bill down the sideboard? Daly starts to move up towards the blue line. 38 seconds to go, though. Looks like it's all over but the shouting. Now it's 4-2 for the Toros. And the young men from Canada have come down and won 6 consecutive games. And certainly hail to them. They have done a fine job representing their country and their Bantam division. Hard shot goes wide. 20 seconds to go. Very personable young fellows, nice coaches, and kudos also to the Bay Harbor boys who really fought the good fight today in this game, made it much closer than last night, played an excellent game, nothing to be ashamed of at all. With 17 seconds to go, it's 4-2, Toronto. The York Toros will win this division, this Bantam division. They've got a lot of good players, very organized coaching, an excellent squad from Canada. Tonight, Toronto defeated Albuquerque here. It was 2 nights ago. They defeated Bay Harbor. I believe the score was 8-1, so the Red Devils, much stronger in this game, really made a fight of it well into the third period. And the Toros with a 2-goal lead, 17 seconds to go, and they have the extra man right now. The draw. Toro's on the attack. Vigilante moving it forward. A backhander. Substitute goalie there getting a lot of action. 5 seconds to go. Oh, and right at the buzzer. 1 second to go. A fight breaks out. That's a shame. That really is a shame. No need for that at all, really. The game is over. The Toros have won it. Let's everybody line up and shake hands. It'd be good sports here. Now the boys from Toronto, Rani Savaliev, Mastrandrea, DeMuro, Gurlio, Paluzzi, Fernicola, Cipino, Carnevale, Carriero, Wolchak, Cashley, Posny, Villa, Iaboni and Vigilante, they are the champions of this tournament. It's been a great game. Winning goalie, Carmelo. And the white shirts did a great job as well. It's been a lot of fun bringing you this Bantam Championship game. To our friends in Canada, I know you're going to enjoy this tape. We'll let you have a look at the Stanley Cup style shake of hands and the award ceremonies, and then we'll try to do some interviews with these fine young players. Johnny Boyle for George Marvel Productions. The Toros win it, go undefeated in the tournament, 6-0. Final score, York 4 and Bay Harbor 2.
Jesse Napier.
For George Marvel Productions. Well, I'll tell you, the boys from Bay Harbor did a fine job here today. They made it much closer in this game. Our first star of the game, Ronnie Marshall. And Ronnie was involved in a play right in front of us there where he bumped with Steve. And the way I saw it, Ronnie, when you reached out, you actually saw him start to crumple and stopped your play and reached out to help him. Am I right on that?
Yeah.
That showed a lot of sportsmanship. Believe me, a lot of class, and I appreciate that. Where are you going to score, Ronnie?
Merrill West High School.
And what grade are you in?
10.
Do you have a favorite player in the National Hockey League?
No.
You're your own favorite player out there, huh? Number 91. You did a fine job. This has been a wonderful tournament, and we really enjoyed seeing you play. And again, congratulations. You guys made one heck of a game out of it today, and better things are coming, I'm sure. A great effort.
Thanks.
Thank you, Ronnie. And some more for Bay Harbor right in here. Who is this?
Hi. Jonathan Castine.
John, how you doing? John, number 35. We had him last time, the big defenseman.
Yeah.
John, number 35 on the back line. And these Toros are tough, but you did much better in this game. What was the difference?
Well, we got our morality pumped up a little bit more, I think.
Got the adrenaline going?
Yeah, we got it going.
Did the job. Congratulations and happy holidays to you, Johnny. Thank you now. In the red shirt right here. Who is this now?
Me!
Okay. Hi, I know who this man is. Give me your name.
Dennis Lefever.
How you doing? I saw you. You're friendly with these Toronto guys. I saw you guys having dinner with them last night. Right?
Oh, that's me, all right.
Look, you're going to be good sports with these guys. Go out and play two hard games and come away friendly, I hope, right?
Yeah, sure.
We wish you the best of the holiday season. Thank you for coming by. And a great effort today, by the way. You did a marvelous job. It was anybody's game today.
Yes, that's right. And thank you. They just had the ref on their side.
They're tough, and you guys did very well, too. Bay Harbor, a good job. Hi, who's this?
Jesse Napier, goalie.
Jesse, I'm glad you're back up on your feet. And, you know, what happened there at the end of the game?
Well, he came in on the breakaway and stick when he shot it. It hit the back of my leg.
Oh, dear. Well, is it just a bruise or what?
Yeah.
Now, who replaced you, by the way, for the last minute? Was that Jeff
Daly?
Okay.
Yeah.
We had Jeff as number 4, but I thought I recognized him from last year, as a matter of fact. 31.
Yeah.
Okay. And where do you go to school, Jesse?
I go to Redondo Union High School.
And what grade are you in?
9th.
Who's your favorite player in the National Hockey League?
Marcus Patrick.
Okay, good enough. We thank you. By the way, you played a fine game today. Those goals, you know, not your fault at all. And I think you guys did very well this afternoon. You know, 4-2, a team now from Canada. Excellent job. You made it so close and so exciting.
Good.
Indeed. Thank you, Jesse. Okay.
Hello, Bill.
Hi, who's this?
Bill Elak.
How you doing?
Fine.
This is Big Bill, number 55, right?
Right.
And, you know, I don't know if you fellas in Southern California have heard this expression, but Bill is a real horse out there. The horse is the big, strong guy that makes his team run. And I look for number 55 there in the middle. Billy, how long have you been playing?
This is my 5th year.
And where do you go to school?
Ridgecrest.
What grade are you in?
8th.
You're an 8th grader. You're a gigantic 8th grader. My goodness. Do you play any other sports?
Baseball.
What position do you play?
I play first base, third base, and catcher.
What do you like best?
Probably catcher.
You're going to be a good athlete. You ever think of taking up wrestling?
No way.
That's my old sport.
I think it's stupid.
Oh, 12 years I did that. 3 years. Let's see, you end up being an announcer this way. Who's your favorite player in the NHL?
Well, I got a lot of faves. I can't say, really.
Good enough. Look, you did very well out there. Congratulations.
Thanks.
On a great tournament. Thank you, Billy. Big Bill does a great job. Here's another big guy. Who's this?
Todd Gibson.
Todd, number 9 out there, the backliner. Todd, these are tough guys out there. They had good speedy forwards, and you guys put the body on them now and then, didn't you, huh?
Yeah, we did.
More so in the second game than in the first.
Yeah, because we knew we were going up to and stuff, so we know we could do it.
Taking a score from 8-1 to 4-2 is a real achievement, as I see it.
Yeah.
Where do you go to school, Todd?
I go to North High.
And what grade are you in?
10.
Do you have a favorite player in the National Hockey League?
All of them.
Oh, there's no one defenseman you like better than anybody else?
Paul Coffey.
Good man. Thank you so much for coming by, and happy holidays to you. Thank you. Here's our big man. We've had him on before. Give us your name again.
I'm Donnie Medeiros.
And Mr. Medeiros, number 15 out there, a real strong player. And congratulations on a fine game today. You made it much, much closer and much, much tougher. And I bet you when those guys go back, they're going to remember you this time, huh?
Yeah.
Show them the California guys can play.
Yeah, we tried.
Holidays ending for you, school coming up again. Is there some school hockey in your future, do you think?
Oh, well, I'm going to try and go back to Minnesota.
Minnesota? No kidding.
Yeah.
Where about in Minnesota do you come from?
Well, I don't come from Minnesota. I just played back there a little while.
Very good. Well, going back from the cold weather in California to the colder weather in Minnesota.
Right.
Great tournament. We really enjoyed seeing you play. Thank you, Don.
Thanks.
Well, to show you one good close-up of the Toros there. And from the pictorial Toro, we have a real Toro. And one of the stars of the game today, this is
Mark Scicchino.
And the winner today, 6-0, undefeated, go back to Canada with the championship trophy. And unfortunately, it's a rainy day for them. They have one more day here in Southern California. What are you going to do with your one day to celebrate? On New Year's Eve, by the way.
I guess just party.
This party? Party in the hotel or party?
Party at the hotel. We got a suite.
Tell us about your trip to Disneyland yesterday.
Oh, it was fun. We went to we went in all the rides, and we went to a club afterwards, and we bought a lot of stuff, souvenirs.
Where do you go to school now? Are you from Toronto or York itself?
I'm from Toronto.
And where about? Where do you go to school?
I go to Michael Powers. It's located in it's on Dundas and Kipling.
Ah.
so.
Well, go back and tell all our friends in Canada that you guys came down here, and if the Maple Leafs, the big Maple Leafs, aren't living up to reputation, you guys certainly did. Congratulations on being a winner here at the tournament today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you now. Some more from the Toros. Here's the big guy. Hi, who's this?
Sasha Ronnie Sabia.
Sasha, how you doing? Sasha, I love your name, first of all. I had a terrible time trying to pronounce it, but I love it. Now, Sasha, is that Russian descent?
Yugoslavian
descent. Yeah. Well, you know, Yugoslavia, Czechoslovakia, they produce some great Olympic-type hockey players. Uh-huh. Where do you go to school?
Me? Yep. I go to Lauren Park High School in Mississauga, Ontario, Canada.
And what grade are you?
Ninth
grader. Now, I bet you watch Hockey Night in Canada up there a lot?
Of course,
every
yeah.
weekend. Who's doing the announcing up there now? Do you remember the name?
Bob Cole.
Okay. Does the name Foster Hewitt or Bill Hewitt ring a bell?
Yeah.
They were the guys when I was
started
up there.
Started it. They
indeed,
started it.
Indeed, they did. You're very well spoken. Are you good in school?
Yeah. Straight A's.
Thought so. I can spot that, George. What are your favorite subjects?
Oh, phys ed, of course.
Okay.
That's about it.
Okay. Well, look, you did a marvelous job. You know, are you pleased with winning the tournament? The California guys gave you a run this time.
Yeah, they really gave us a run, but we handled them. You know, we handled them pretty well.
Indeed, you did.
Yeah, we got scared a while there. When we got the penalty with 2 minutes left,
right?
We got real scared there.
You know, I saw Sasha talking in the coffee shop last night with some of the boys here. Did you make any friends while you were here in Southern California?
Oh, yeah, a lot.
You know, that's really a good
a
part of this, really. We thank you so much for coming by. You boys are great representatives of your country, and I hope, you know, everybody friends, the Canadian boys, the American guys friends, and let's promote hockey. And Sasha, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Well-spoken young man. We had this man on once before, but we're going to say hello again. This is number 9, is that right?
Yep.
Now, your first name, I've been calling you Lewis, but is it Luigi?
Either one, doesn't matter.
Okay, well, look, so fast out there and buzzing around the net and does so well. Are you happy with the championship today?
Yeah, very happy.
6-0, isn't that great? Take that back to Canada and show the tape to all your buddies up there, huh?
Yep.
How did you like Disneyland yesterday?
We went to Universal Tours.
Universal Tours, huh?
Yeah.
Well, look. Enjoy yourself, have a good time, and go back as winners. Thank you now.
Thanks.
Okay, I see Alex in back of me here. Come on in, Alex, for a minute. Alex, I don't know what your nickname is. Here's a very well-spoken young man. We talked last night also. And Alex, I have given you a nickname. It would be funny if it stuck with you for the rest of your hockey player career. I'm glad you're wearing this because I was calling you Alex the Hat during the game. Do you like that as a nickname?
I know.
Well, you could make it short for Hat Trick. How is that? Does that sound good? Alex, how many goals today?
I think 2.
And fast, and they were the deciding ones, too. You are some player out there. Who do you model yourself on? Anybody special?
Not really.
It seems to me that Alex can go and get a goal when he really wants to go and get a goal. Is that true? Very good. Did you enjoy your trip? Did you go to Universal Studios yesterday or Disneyland?
I went to Disneyland.
You went to Disneyland. A little partying tonight, perhaps, for New Year's Eve?
Mm-hmm.
You got the championship, and congratulations. A very personable young man. We'll look for you on Hockey Night in Canada in the near future, eh?
Thank you,
Alex. Take care of that hat now. Okay, for the Toros, who is this?
Carmelo Gioia.
Carmelo, how you doing? Carmelo, we had a chance to speak to your dad before the game started. You are number 1. I used to play goal up in Chicoutimi, Quebec some years ago, and I like goalies who still wear number 1. To me, that's the goalie's number. Yeah. Number 2 is for the all-star defenseman. Number 1 is for the goalie. Congratulations. How did you get into goaltending?
Well, my first year, my coach tried me in net, and I just went on from there.
Nobody had your coach tried you, or did you want to go yourself?
Well, my coach put me in. Like, he puts everybody in to try.
Oh, is that right? Really?
Yeah.
Give everyone a chance at it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Where do you go to school?
In Toronto.
And what's the name of the school? Tell us the name.
Leonardo da Vinci Academy.
Really? This is an interesting name for a school. Da Vinci High School. What grade are you in?
9.
And who's your favorite player in the National Hockey League? Is it a goalie?
Yeah.
Who is it?
Alan Bester.
Well, good man. We congratulate you on coming down here and winning the championship game. Have a nice time in Southern California. And
thanks.
Enjoy the trip back to Canada. Say hello to everybody for me on King Street up there.
Okay.
Thank you now. And this young man, he's a good, well-spoken, good-looking young guy. We have spoken before. Give him your name again.
David DeMauro,
number 2.
David DeMauro,
pardon me. David, a goal scorer out there. David, you look like you could be doing commercials. Maybe we'll see you doing one for Molson's one of these days up in Canada, huh?
No.
No chance of that?
No, don't drink beer.
Okay, well, how about this Pepsi or Coke then in that case?
No problem.
You enjoyed today's game?
Yep.
4-2, they gave you a battle this time. They improved a little. And you guys go back with the title. Did you make it to Disneyland yesterday or Universal Studios?
No, Universal Studios.
The big Jaws guy didn't get you when you were there, huh?
No, it was interesting.
I'm glad you liked it. Congratulations on winning the tournament. You people live up to your reputation, win all your games, and go back happy.
Thanks.
Have a good trip back down. Thank you. Right here with the black jacket. Who's this?
Sam Iovone.
And Sam, the goalie, we have Sam on two tapes. Sam, the winning goalie on the other two games we taped for the Toronto Toros. And Sam, how did you find this tournament? Well, how the California boys strike you as players?
They came out right off the bat, and we just responded whenever they would come in our end. We were hitting them. And they had chances, we had chances, but I think overall we were the better team.
How did you become a goaltender, Sam? Who decided to put you between the pipes?
Myself. Well, my first year, I was playing house league and they didn't have a goaltender, so coach asked us and I volunteered.
Where do you go to school, Sam?
Father Henry Carr.
And what year are you in?
99.
Do you have a favorite player in the NHL?
Yeah.
Who do you have? Who do you like?
Wendell Clark.
Okay, Wendell Clark, yourself. Champions, back to Toronto, undefeated. Show this tape to the good neighbors up there and have a lot of fun in the holiday season.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sam. Good going there for the goalie. Anybody else with Toronto wants to come on? We've got to get our next game ready, a square championship game. The coach, yes, come on. Tell you the coach, and let's get the businessman. He has been so good to us today, getting the Toronto guys over. Anybody else? It's got to be quick. Toronto, the winners. Oh, come on, coach. I got it. It's been so personable helping us round up the Toronto players during this entire tournament. I wanted him to come on and say hello, and I'm sure you are so pleased with the play of these guys.
It was, they played well. They came on in the third period, and they managed to pull it off. That was good that way. I was very happy with them.
It's been a great trip down for Toronto. It will be a happy trip home for you as well, right, with that big championship trophy?
Definitely. Maybe I can show it to you, too.
Oh, here we go. Here's what we've been playing for, folks. Maybe the Stanley Cup one day, but this trophy will do it till that comes along. Lord Stanley's Cup maybe was never as hard won, maybe as this one is. And we thank all the Toronto Toros and the friends and coaches and players who have been here and given us such a good exhibition of hockey, perhaps the way hockey should be played and has been played in the great tradition from Toronto. Johnny Boyle for George Marble Productions. That's all for this time. Until next time. Goodbye, everybody, and happy holidays.
Bye.
Close this tape without talking to big number 77, David Vigilante. And David, in the tradition of Esposito with the double sevens on your back, a great tournament. Are you pleased?
Yeah, we played a good tournament.
Southern California treating you okay even though it's raining today?
Yeah, they treated us good. Our billets treated us well.
I'm very glad. And I've been very impressed by your players and by your teammates. Real gentlemen, first of all. Great players, secondly. And thank you so much for coming down to visit us. And have a great trip home to Toronto. And you take the championship home with you.
Thanks.
David Vigilante, a fine player for the Toros. Thank you now. And again, didn't want to sign it off without saying that. We've got a young man over here to hold the trophy up. And we'll sign it off. Who is this?
Andrea.
Mastrandrea. Hold the trophy up, Andrea. There it is. That's that little private trophies they've gotten. You did a great job. Number 7 out there on the back line. Where do you go to school?
St. Bart's College.
And what grade are you in?
9.
Do you have a favorite player in the NHL?
Tocchet.
Well, you picked good ones. All the Toros here, happy celebrating their victory in the championships. We got to go. We got to do the squirt game next. Johnny Boyle for George Marble Productions saying goodbye, everybody. Happy holidays. Maybe the best news for last. Steve Paluzzi, injured in the game, got back on the ice before it was over and standing with me now, hale and hearty and healthy and the champion. Steve, how you feeling?
Better.
Survive that all right. It's going to be a happy trip back to Toronto.
I hope so.
With the trophy. Where do you go to school, Steve?
Where do I go?
Where do you go to school?
Father Henry Carr.
And what grade are you in?
9.
Any favorite player in the NHL?
Wayne Gretzky.
Good man. We are so glad that you're feeling okay again. Standing here with me as we sign it off, Johnny Boyle for George Marble Productions. The Toros take it and take the trophy back to Toronto. That's all for this time. Till next time, goodbye, everybody, and happy holidays.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have...